Hi guys, welcome back. So now it is official, OnePlus 5T is going to come next week, or going to launch next week, and after a couple of days from now you can pre-order it. So if you are going there, maybe you can just buy it from there. So we are going to see in this video whether you should buy this OnePlus 5T or not. So I'm going to divide this video on the two perspective. Number one thing, in case you own any of the 3, 3T, 5, which I'm using on a regular basis, so whether you should upgrade that or not. And the second thing, you know, as a non-OnePlus user, if you like this device a lot, you heard about it a lot, whether you should buy OnePlus 5T or not. If you're not going to buy it, if I'm saying not to buy it, what are the possible alternatives? So let's jump in. First thing, we're going to start and see what are the new features that is going to come. So the best thing that is going to come in this 5T is obviously the 18:9 display that Galaxy started. So that is a highlight because it has been leaked by so many popular online leaks, like the EV leaks, like there is a device 18:9 under work, and even the OnePlus also teased a lot of things. And the second is that is going to come is an improvement of the camera. So OnePlus co-founder teased a lot of photos on their Twitter account, like, you know, improvement in the portrait mode and improvement in the low lighting. So it's not sure whether there is going to be any huge megapixel change on the back side. Probably if they're going to use the same megapixels, they will use some different camera sensor. But if you compare with the last year, like 3 and 3T, they both are using the same camera sensor. But OnePlus 3T is taking better photos because they improved the camera logic algorithm. There probably something going to happen with the OnePlus 5T also. And there is a headphone jack. Again, there is no wireless charging, and there is no waterproofing. All things are same. So maybe these things are going to come in the next OnePlus 6. So that makes sense, guys. That is why I'm just saying don't buy it. So let's start first with the OnePlus. As a OnePlus user, what are my opinions whether you should buy OnePlus 5T or not? So starting off, guys, if you guys can see, OnePlus 3 got delivered to me on 15 June. That means you guys might have purchased the same day. So it's around 18 months old. OnePlus 3T, 12 December 2016 on the Amazon same. So just an 11 month old device. OnePlus 5 got delivered on 24th of June. So this is just 4 month old device. So 18 month, 11 month, and the 4 month. Now keep this OnePlus 5 apart. Let's talk about 3 and 3T. So you know, guys, I'm showing you guys almost all of the updates for the whatever OxygenOS builds came for the OnePlus 3 and 3T, OnePlus 5. So this 3 and 3T, they are being treated same as, you know, like they are the same devices. Even though there is a 7 month difference, there's a difference of 1 year generation of the processor, but still they are being treated as the same. So technically, if you take on the software, any flagship device, whether you take mid-range or big one, they all get at least 2 years of the software support. So this OnePlus 3T is going to get their last version of Android, that is Android 8.0. So you know, for OnePlus 3, we can understand it is 18 to 19 month old, so the last version of Android is okay. But how about 3T, guys? This is just 11 month old, and this is the last version of the Android that you're going to get. So generally with each device, you know, in 2 years software support, you can of course get 3 versions of Android, but this device is going to get only 2. So probably bad luck for 3T users. You know, there is nothing too much improvement, just on the processor, slightly improved camera, but they are being treated the same way. Performance is great for both the devices, so that is a problem. You know, OnePlus as a manufacturer, they release flagship each year. The OnePlus 6 probably going to come launch on the May, and you can buy it on the June. So between the OnePlus 6 and the 5T, there is a difference of not more than 6 months. So definitely, if you own a OnePlus 3, so if you really wanted to have it, OnePlus 5T is a great choice. But I told you the cons on the software side. You're gonna suffer after a few months because that is what happens, and companies that try to do the same thing. You know, this is a smaller company, even big companies do the same stuff. Again, guys, so I would recommend from my side, in case you own any 3, 3T and OnePlus 5, so do not upgrade to OnePlus 5T. But at the end, this is your money. In case you're really desperate, you are a huge OnePlus fan, you know, you buy all the devices, so then go ahead, buy it. There is no need for, you know, talking to me whether I should buy that device or not. But in case you don't own any of the OnePlus device, still you want to come that, I will still say wait for the OnePlus 6, but still is secure. In case you're very desperate, go ahead and buy OnePlus 5T. So guys, again, don't take me wrong, this is a great device. I'm not saying OnePlus 5T is not going to be a great device. OnePlus 5T is a spectacular device, works flawlessly, nice camera, everything is okay. But still, guys, you know, in terms of software, this is going to happen same like what happened with the 3T. So that's why I mentioned, do not buy OnePlus 5T just because of the software, not because of the device is not great. So definitely taller display is going to look much cooler. so device will be better. So as far as mine concern, I'm going to buy OnePlus 5T because, you know, I have to give you guys review whether is there really any huge difference, at least in terms of the camera, since both the phones are going to have the same processor. So technically there should not be any difference in terms of the cam performance also. They are going to run the same version of the Oxygen OS that you have with OnePlus 5. So again, there's no difference. So just because of a taller display and slightly improved camera, if there is any, so you should not be, you know, spending a lot of money. And now the price is again going to increase by 4 to 5K. So that device is now, I guess, 37, 38K for the 8GB RAM model. So this time, I believe this is going to be near about the 40 or 40+K. If you really wanted to have such a great device, buy Galaxy S8, but you are going to suck on the software. So this is about that. Now guys, one more thing I am thinking, you know, I don't have any problem, you know, from the OnePlus company. They are going to release two devices in a year, but the problem is that they are going to release two flagship in a year. Consider the Galaxy, you know, they have the different Galaxy Note series, Galaxy S series, even though they all run the same processor, same RAM, slightly different version of the software, but still both devices are kind of different. Galaxy is a Note, Galaxy Note is a different device, phablet device. S series is slightly stylish, sporty looking device. So they both have different kind of user. But again, on the OnePlus, they are just releasing based on if there is new processor game. For example, OnePlus 3T, they got 1800 display ratio, dollar display, they release a new device. So I don't like it really. If the OnePlus wanted to have a device, you know, just try to release maybe OnePlus 5S or OnePlus 5 mini, you know, why I'm telling you, you know, not everybody needs such a high performing flagship device. I mean, what you're going to do with 6 or 8 GB of RAM? You guys know that, you know, for example, you are a power user, your family members using this Android device, definitely, I'm just assuming. So not everybody needs 6 GB, 8 GB of RAM. Not everybody needs such a great camera. Like the casual users, they like great camera, but they just need 3 GB, 4 GB of RAM, and basically the budget is moon concern. Not everybody wants to spend on the 35-40K. Most of the people in India are buying phones under, you know, the 20K-25K is a max budget. So if the OnePlus 5 releases a device, you know, the same Oxygen OS, same fingerprint sensor, same camera, or maybe a single camera or slightly lower camera with the same dash charging, with the 4 GB of RAM, and you know, with the lower Snapdragon 625 with a budget of 20 or maybe max 25K, then that device is going to be a mind-blowing crazy. Like you have the, you know, Motorola devices under the same 15K budget segment. So 15K to 20K is a great budget, like the Xiaomi devices are doing. So if company releases such a device, like, you know, smaller version of their flagship, so that is going to be, I guess, a very different strategy. OnePlus going to make a lot of money with that. But again, they're just trying to release device based on what games in the device, and you know, I don't like this thing. I don't have any problem with the device, I'm using it, but the way they're releasing devices, it is wrong. So that is why, guy, I mentioned, do not buy OnePlus 5T, wait for OnePlus 6. Otherwise, after 1 year, you will again post me on this comment, or you can again go to the OnePlus forum and you will say OnePlus cheated us, you know, why this device is not going to get Android P and after that upgrade. So kind of stuff, I know that, because in just 2 years using this device, I know the same thing. So guys, this is my thoughts on OnePlus 5T. Again, it's a great device, but still, in case you desperately want to upgrade from 3 and 3T, then OnePlus 5T is a great choice. Do not buy OnePlus 5, even though it is available in India, buy OnePlus 5T. Otherwise, if software is really where you're concerned, you're going to use this device at least for 2 to 3 years, and you need software support, then OnePlus, wait for OnePlus 6, not for the 5T. So thank you for watching, guys. This is Saurabh. Hope you guys didn't understand my words. I'll talk to you very soon. Have a great day.